Today, we're showing you how you can get your hands on your very own custom wine cabinet. I'm thrilled to be joined today by Ben and Damon, and we are standing right in front of what I'd like to call the show cellar of the century. Holy smokes. Ben, I'm gonna start with you because you made this magnificent piece of art.
The thing about this cabinet is this was an afterthought after we were almost finished with this kitchen remodel. The owner wanted to make sure that they can get their wine storage into the house, but they didn't have a cellar, and they didn't have area in the rest of the house to put it. So we were challenged. We were challenged with space, we were challenged with creativity, and we were challenged to come up with an aesthetic that was gonna meet the rest of this actually quite beautiful place.
If I do say so myself, I tried to bring my suitcase, but they were like, get out, Monique.
So we looked at every possible commercially made and also custom made cabinets that had the mechanism and the mechanicals inside of them to put in this space. The problem we ran into was the depth. If you see, it's completely flush with the rest of the kitchen. So what ended up happening was that this cabinet was custom designed with all of the mechanicals built up through the roof. And that was really one of the things that made the challenge the hardest. How are we gonna get a unit into this space and be able to keep it at the temperature? Different wines require different temperatures, so we have multiple areas with different temperatures, and they all had to be dealt with the mechanicals.
And that's, yeah, I really wanna hit that because people, a lot of people see wine cabinets and they're like, oh, okay, well, it's a wine cabinet, what's the big deal? Well, this is stored at proper temperature. So this is refrigerated, which is a lot different than just shoving your wine under your bed or on top of your refrigerator. God forbid, don't put it on top of the fridge. This is a climate-controlled wine cabinet, which, Damon, I want to turn to you a little bit to talk about how important is it to store your wine properly?
Well, if you want to drink your wine anytime after, you know, 6 months or a year, then it's pretty important. Wines will just immediately start changing and start changing too fast if they're not stored at the right temperature.
And so people at home, they're watching, they're going, well, what do you mean, right temperature? I don't even know what you're talking about. 75, 80 degrees the right temperature? That's how hot my house is.
Well, I think there's some misconceptions about the exact right temperature. It's not as important the exact right temperature. It's more the consistency is what everybody says is most important, the real experts. But if you're going to put the trouble into building such an amazing, beautiful cabinet, then you probably want to have it be able to refrigerate at 50 to 55 degrees.
50 to 5 degrees would be storing temperature. What would you say would be drinking temperature for reds and whites?
Well, I tend to start with my reds right out of the cellar, and I open them and I start to drink them and smell them at that temperature, and then I let them come up to room temperature over a period of time. With white wines, you tend to want them to stay at, you know, maybe 60 to 65 degrees, and you start drinking them, you keep them cool so that you can keep them in that temperature range.
Talk a little bit about how you probably, I'm guessing, I'm no expert, work with the clients to kind of really make their piece of art or their dream come true when it comes to, say, a wine cabinet.
Exactly, and in this particular case, it was very important to him that it felt like it was both a part of the house and a piece of art. So all of the wood was chosen for that. We have a walnut exterior, we have an unfinished cherry interior. Each of these doors is hermetically sealed with ridiculous magnets that allow us to hold in the temperature and to keep them exactly right. The owner can look through over here and see what the temperature is at any given moment, and then in here, we have the little digital temperatures to make sure that it's absolutely correct.
When you say hermetically sealed, I think of that skit from Johnny Carson. Does anybody remember he had the thing, hermetically sealed in the mayonnaise jar at McMahon?
Yeah.
I just totally tell everyone how old I am. I know that you're not a real estate expert, but I would imagine that putting an investment like this, like a wine cabinet or any other investments in your home, probably helps with resale.
Oh, I would think absolutely. In all of the projects that we do, when someone puts something custom in, as long as it makes sense with the rest of the house and it's beautiful and functional, it adds value. And it's not what I call a polarizer, right? So as Monique said before, if this was all San Francisco Giants or 49ers and still a beautiful piece, it might not work for every kind of buyer. But this piece is gonna work for anybody who loves this house, loves this view, and really loves their wine.
If you wanna keep a wine for 20 years, you really wanna have to be able to maintain the temperature and the humidity so that it ages in a graceful way.
I hope to age in a graceful way. Cheers, gentlemen. Thank you so much.